they made their rounds of the city. Have you seen him whom my heart loves? I had hardly left them when I found him whom my heart loves. The word of the Lord. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God.
My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God.
O God, you are my God whom I seek. For you my flesh pines and my soul thirsts like the earth, parched, lifeless, and without water. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God. Thus have I gazed toward you in the sanctuary, to see your power and your glory. For your kindness is a greater good than life. My lips shall glorify you. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God. Thus will I bless you while I live. Lifting up my hands, I will call upon your name. As with the riches of a banquet shall my soul be satisfied, and with exultant lips my mouth shall praise you. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God. You are my help, and in the shadow of your wings I shout for joy. My soul clings fast to you. Your right hand upholds me. My soul is thirsting for you, my God.
both the beloved, both the spouses of the Lord, called to proclaim the good news. But the bride in that first reading is so much like the church. Each and every one of us longing for the Lord, each of us seeking Him out, seeking Him who gives love to our lives, the foundation of our very existence. Mary Magdalene, again the image of the church, called out of sinfulness to the glory of the resurrection, called to witness the risen Christ, as we will do in the reception of the Holy Eucharist, in the gift of the Blessed Sacrament. As Mary receives the risen Lord, so too do we receive new life in the body and blood of Jesus Christ. Just like the church, like Mary Magdalene, like the bride, like each and every one of us, we're called to go out and announce the good news. Go out and proclaim the kingdom. And just as our Holy Father Pope Francis reminded us in the documents released this past week, each and
you upheld us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Alfred, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Edward, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who is united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in bread.